Hey guys, I'm Tori Sterling. Welcome back to my channel. Today I'm doing a health Q&A. If you're wondering, Tori, why do you look so bad? I can tell you why. It's because my hair's wet, just got out of the shower. That's normally what happens, your hair gets wet. And I'm only wearing mascara and a little bit of a tinted brow gel and of course lip gloss because you can only ever wear lip gloss everywhere. I asked you guys on Twitter and Instagram to tweet me questions about how to get into fitness if you wanna begin it but you don't know where to start, all that sorts of good jazz. I asked you guys to tweet me it and DM me on the Insta, and I got a lot of questions, so let's just get started. But if you guys are new to my channel, please subscribe before the video continues because it helps me out a lot. And also, while you're there, just go down, hit that little like button, and yes. As a beginner, how do you motivate yourself to start working out? I'm honestly so on and off with it and I have no motivation. So this was me for like, I'm not kidding, a year and a half to 2 years before I got really into fitness. And I got into fitness about a year and a half ago. So for me, how it started was honestly one day I was sitting in Qdoba and I just hit rock bottom. I was like, I'm unhappy with my weight. I'm unhappy with my diet. I don't like how I feel. I don't like how I look. Everything about me, I just do not like right now. So I was like, this is it. Like, I'm done living like this. I'm done being a victim to my own habits and to my own life, and I'm gonna take a, you know, I'm gonna make a change out of it, and I'm gonna be happy with my life again. So that's what happened, and I went home and I started researching new diets and I started reading books. I read Skinny Bitch and that was amazing. Honestly, this sounds kind of harsh, but I think one day you will just hit rock bottom where you're sort of done with your lifestyle and where you'd really just want to get to that point that you've always wanted to be at. And honestly, it's kind of hard to get there, but I say just do it, because honestly, nothing bad can come out of you starting this journey of health and fitness. Absolutely nothing can come out poorly of this. It only promotes a healthy lifestyle, a good life, happiness. Everything about health and fitness is the key to being happy. You cannot fail at this. What do you do to get out of a health funk? Hashtag losing motivation. From the very beginning, I always say take progress pictures. So from where you like do not like your body, do not like how you feel, look, whatever it may be, take progress pictures as your starting photos, and also write down goals. What do you want to feel like at the end of this? There is also never gonna be an end, but just say like, how do I want to feel? What do I want to accomplish? It could be something as simple as like, I wanna fit into my size 6 leggings a little bit better. Or it could be like, I wanna wake up not tired from, you know, eating junk food. Whatever it might be, write down your goals, what you wanna feel like, and take pictures. When you're starting to lose motivation, first off, revisit those goals and remember why you're doing this in the first place. Secondly, I need you to remember that this is a journey, it is hard, it is a lifestyle. It's not gonna be like a quick little bump in the road, but once you start and you get addicted to it, you're not gonna wanna stop, trust me there. Remember that it is hard work, and even though like sometimes it feels like you're not getting to see any results, that's probably because you're just starting out. So keep at it. Go with it for 2 more weeks, then 1 more month. You know, just keep working, and then you'll see your own results, and then you will be your own motivation. Because once you see results, it makes you just want to keep going stronger and harder and better and eating healthier and cleaner. Just keep doing it until you start seeing a little bit of results, and you will want to keep going. I promise. You just have to really push through. That first month is the hardest. The second month gets easier. How to be confident in the gym. Okay, this is very tricky. So the first thing that I recommend is to just put yourself out there and just go. No matter whether it's a spin studio or an actual gym itself or a new workout class, whatever it might be, just go. Because everybody had to step foot in a gym for the first time at some point in their life. And you are not gonna be an outcast. Honestly, nobody cares what you're doing except for you. Like, I literally had to tell myself that the other day when I went to go jacuzzi at my gym. I was like, I feel really weird right now, but then I had to tell myself, I was like, literally no one gives a shit except for me what I'm doing right now. So I just need to get out of my own head and suck it up and go. The more you force yourself to go, the more you will get confident, and you know, honestly, fake it till you make it. Honestly, the more you go, the more confident you'll begin to get. Favorite thing to eat when you have a sweet tooth. So I love making a banana ice cream. It's so, so simple. All it is 2 frozen bananas, slap of peanut butter, a little bit of almond milk, blend it up and eat it like ice cream, and it's amazing. It's healthy, tastes like ice cream. What advice slash tips would you give to someone who's a beginner to fitness? So I would say keep going and keep doing it. I know that it's like this new intimidating world. And oh, that's another thing, never stop learning because there's always something. Also, it really helps if you have a buddy, whether that's your mom, your best friend, I don't know. I would say never stop learning, keep going to the gym, keep going to your workout classes, keep trying healthy foods, find what you like, find what you don't like, experiment a little bit, play around a little bit, get a little crazy here and there. But honestly, you just have to start. That's the biggest thing, is to just start and stick with it. Don't give up on yourself. Give yourself like 30 days of a totally healthy lifestyle change, and I promise you, you will be hooked and you won't want to stop because you'll feel how amazing you feel, and that's motivation in itself to keep on going. How do you stay healthy and find time to exercise during school when you're starting to get really busy? So I'm going to do an entire video on how to stay healthy in college because a ton of people ask me that, but to like quickly sum it up, you make time for what you want to. So if you want to go to the gym, or you want to go on a run, or you want to do like a dorm room fitness thing or whatever, but you're starting to get really busy, wake up a half an hour earlier and just to do a little in the dorm workout or go on a run. You make time for what you want to, whether that means waking up an hour earlier, 30 minutes earlier, like you're gonna prioritize it if you want to. If you wanna work out that day, you are going to. So like just like how you would prioritize like taking a shower, it's like look at the gym or look at working out as part of like your hygiene routine. Like it's good to do for 30 minutes a day, 20, 30 minutes, just to keep yourself hygienic and fit. Like it should just become a part of your routine. Obviously it's important to eat healthy all your life, but at what age would you say you really need to focus on your fitness and foods you're putting into your body? I feel like that's important because everybody, when they turn, like I feel like every mom is like fit and like goes to the gym and tries to eat healthy, but everyone's like, when do you like hit that point in your life where that's like your new? So for me, my mom growing up always fed me very well, very healthy, always kept me very active. So as a kid, I learned that like that's like the way to live your life. And then when I became a teenager, I kind of was like, I had my own freedom and I was able to eat whatever I want. So then I sort of stopped, but then I was like, I noticed that my body started getting bigger and I was gaining weight and I didn't feel as good. And I was like, oh God, like this is what happens when you stop taking care of yourself. When I got my period, my mom was like, okay, like now is where normally girls start gaining weight. You're gonna have to feed your body properly because now if you, you know, eat an entire pizza, your body can kind of put it on, it can kind of show it. And I was like, I'm fine. And then I would eat entire pizzas and it was true. So for me, I would say you have to start young because that's just how you grow up. But if, I mean, obviously we're all older than young now. So I would say when you start your period is when you really should begin to eat your healthiest. And that's just because that's when your body's going through changes in puberty. And that's when your metabolism tends to begin to slow down. And you know, if you already have your period and you're already past that, I'd say do it now. So for me, it's just when you get your period. That doesn't mean like you should be like 13 and like pumping a out of iron in the gym. Like no, it just means like go for a little run, maybe some, eat like some vegetables instead of like a side of french fries, you know what I mean, just like little substitutes here and there to incorporate healthy habits into your daily life. Okay, this is a good question. How often should you work out during the week and for what duration? So that really depends on you and your schedule. I would always recommend to work out at least 3 to 4 times a week. And then for how long, it depends on the workout. Like if you're doing like a HIIT, you can only, you know, 20 minutes is enough for that. If you're doing like lifting and stuff, maybe like 45 minutes. If you're doing like a spin class, that's a 45 minute class. If you're running or you're sprinting, you know, you can only do that for like however long you want. Like if you're sprinting, let's say like a 15 minute, you know, sprint training thing, and if you're running like a 5 mile run, that's like a 50 minute thing. So it really just depends on the workout for the duration, but I would definitely say 3 to 4 times a week. Once a day is fine. I mean, I'm crazy and I work out literally 4 times a day, like 6 days a week. So I don't know why I do that, honestly. I just do it because it's kind of like addicting at this point. So when I say workout, I mean like I do like hot yoga, then I lift, and then I'll normally take like 2 spin classes a day. Or I'll take like Pilates. I'm getting into kickboxing lately, so I don't know, I just switch it up. But yeah, you definitely don't need to go as crazy as I am. I honestly think I do it just to keep myself busy because like I work from home, I live at home. I don't really have like friends that live at home right now. They're all back at college. So it's kind of like I just leave my house to keep me busy. and I don't want to go to Starbucks and sit on my laptop, so I just work out all the time. That's like my logic in my head. You don't need to do that. I'm crazy about that. I don't know why I do that, honestly. But 3 to 4 times a week definitely is good. Once a day, totally fine. And the duration depends on you. Just make sure that you get a good sweat on and you feel like you're actually accomplishing something, because it's a waste if you go to the gym and you just sort of sit there and you're like, do like 5 crunches and you're like, okay, I'm done. Like, come on. Okay, this is also another really important question that I do feel kind of strongly about. How do you deal with body imperfections after consistently working out for a long time? I know it can be discouraging because you can seemingly be doing everything right and not have the perfect body. I'd love to hear your response. So working out is not just about the physical aspect of it. Like, I work out so much and I don't have like cut abs. I don't have perfectly toned arms. Like, that's just no. But I feel so much better. And like, every time I see a picture of myself, I'm not like, really, Tori? Because I know I'm not letting myself go. Like, I'm not, you know, being like, whatever, like, let me just eat these cheese fries and call it a day. No, I'm eating right. I'm working out a ton. So even though it can be discouraging that you don't have the perfect body, I just want you to remember that all the Instagram models that you see, or, you know, Kylie Jenner, a lot of times they're either photoshopped or they know how to pose their body right. No one has a perfect body, because everyone has the idea of what a perfect body is. Like, it's very personal. Like, for me, if I could sculpt the perfect body, it's totally probably not what you would think of as the perfect body. Your body is not gonna be like anyone else's body. It's unique, it's individual, it's special. That's what makes it cool. It's your own body, it's your home. Okay, so a bunch of these questions I have pretty much answered all of the questions to. I keep getting like pretty much the same questions asked a bunch of times, which is fine because that means everyone wants to know the answers. But I think I answered them to the best of my ability. So that is it. I hope you guys enjoyed this video. I hope it helped you out in some way. Comment your biggest health tip for any beginners that are watching this vid and want to know how to get started. Love you guys. Thank you guys for watching even when I looked like a little drowned rat. Love you guys, and I'll talk to you in my next video. Subscribe. Goodbye.